Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. I hope you're doing well, and in today's video I am testing all of the viral things that I've seen on TikTok shop recently and give you a little review for each piece and tell you whether it's worth it or not. TikTok shop at the moment has become huge and I don't know why, I just get influenced so easily with it, just end up buying everything that I see. I'm just gonna get on with the video. I hope you enjoy, and if you haven't already, please make sure you subscribe. First up, I've actually seen this brand floating around on TikTok for a while, and I myself have used them so many times. I've got proof. These are the previous ones that I've bought. If you're wanting to get the photos on your phone developed into actual photos, then that is what Freeprints is for. This part of the video is actually sponsored by Freeprints, but obviously I've used them before many times and I love them. So there's so many different ways you can get the photos developed, all different sizes. You can also get them into books and things like that. Personally, I just print out the standard 6x4 and then just keep them. So what I like to do every year is print out all of my favourite memories from that year and have like a little keepsake, just for if I want to put anything in a frame or just to look back on. You never know what's going to happen to the photos on your phone. Also save storage on your phone, getting them printed out. I just love looking back on these photos. These photos are from about 7 years ago, I want to say, some of them. Probably slightly embarrassing. Freeprints have also very kindly given a code for you guys. I want to say it's Aim Louise or Aim Blythe 115. I think it's Aim Louise 115, which actually gets you 15 prints for absolute free. Free delivery, just so you can give them a little go. Honestly, it is so cheap if you did want to order more anyway. It is like £3 each time I order a photo, bunch of photos. It's honestly great. Whether you wanted to get them developed like this, or you can get them in a cute little photo book, which I also think is so nice. I'll show you the ones that I've got printed out. Pictures from my holiday in Sorrento, and I don't know if you can see, but the quality of that is absolutely insane. Sorrento again, Ayia Napa, Tenerife, Sorrento. That was Positano, Sorrento again. St. Ives, cute little night out photo. First time we got Wally, look how bloody cute he was. He was so precious, so precious. A little weekend in Scarborough. They are just so good to look back on and keep. Coldplay, and like I say, the quality is insane to me. Quality is absolutely insane, and I just think they are such a lovely thing to do. Get all your photos printed out, you know, pretty old school, but I bloody love it. It's the best app to go to. If you want the cheapest and quickest way to develop some little memories, Freeprints is your place. I'm gonna timestamp the video. So we've got fashion, beauty, and then makeup. So if you want to go to the little section that you're interested about, you're welcome. First up, I'm going to mention my absolute favorite purchase that I have made from TikTok shop, the UGG boots. Now, these are looking slightly worse for wear because I wear them all the freaking time. These are on my feet every time I go out. I think it's because they're just so easy to chuck on. I mean, well, I'm not gonna lie, I don't think the UGG boots are the nicest looking thing. I mean, they literally just look like slippers. But I do not want to pay the full price of the ultra mini Uggs. It is a weird fashion trend. It's like Crocs, ugly shoes. Don't know if I'm a fan. I decided to get the dark grey because I've got a grey coat and I'm really enjoying the colour grey at the moment, if you couldn't tell. These little bad boys were £30. They are fur lined and they've got like a little label. Sorry if you can see the dirt. Got a little label at the back and I've had them for a couple of months. They are starting to crease at the toe, but am I still gonna wear them? Yes, I absolutely love them. They are the comfiest things ever. I've got mine in a size 4 and that is my true size. And honestly, they fit like a dream. So, so comfortable. I'm obsessed. I think I might have to buy another color because I just completely adore them. Next up, we have the viral corset. I'm not gonna do this justice. I'm actually going to tie it up, bear with. This little corset was going around TikTok like mad. I think the blue one was like the most popular, but I needed a white one. So how cute, first of all. You can probably see like the quality looks so nice. This does actually fit me quite well. I just feel quite bare in it. It's like literally lingerie basically. And the back has like very nice crisscrossy kind of thing. And this bodysuit was a tenner. £10. Absolute bargain. The cups fit really nice. There's no boning in the cups, but you know, for a tenner, what do you expect? And there's little droopy bits here. It's just really nice. And the middle is actually hook and eye detail. For a tenner, you literally cannot go wrong. And they did loads of different colours as well. I got mine in a size 10 and it's true to size. If you want a corset, give this one a go. This actually arrived a couple of days ago and I tried it on today and I'm absolutely gutted it does not fit. I got a size 8 to 10 and I should have got the 10 to 12, but I just thought it would be stretchy, but it's actually so short on the leg. So I'm hoping if I size up, it will be not as short. So I don't know if you can tell, but it's the viral fleece little jumpsuit kind of thing. I don't know why I thought it was fleece on the inside, but really it's just like a really soft kind of fleecy material. So soft, and it would be really nice and super flattering if I got the right size. That was literally the only thing, it was just too short for me, so I'm hoping it's not going to be too big when I get the next size. I did actually see on the little slip that came with the parcel you can return these, so I am going to return it even though it was only £12. Gonna get my money back and get the next size up. Just a super simple piece, chuck it on with like a nice big coat, the UGG boots, good to go. Comfort is key in winter, I think. Anyway, really nice, super soft, and yeah, absolutely love it, and I will be buying the next size up. Next up we have the gilet that went viral. So this was £13, which is unreal for a gilet, but everyone was raving about like how good quality it is, how thick it is. I don't think it is. Sorry, I don't. So thin. It's like paper thin. This would not keep me warm. I could wear this in like 40 degree heat and it will make a difference to my body temperature. There's just nothing to it. It does look nice, really nice and cropped. And for the money, you know, I think in spring I will probably still wear it. It's just not doing anything. I don't know why I expect it, to be fair. It's not doing anything in the winter time. So yeah, it is nice with like, say if you wore the jumpsuit with it, it'd look really nice. Your kidneys would be very cold if you wore this at this time of year. Next up, we have the most expensive thing that I've ever bought on TikTok shop. And we're moving on to here. Colour Wow Dream Coat Supernatural Spray. My hairdresser actually influenced me to buy this because she's a fan of TikTok shop as well. She used up my hair, and I could definitely notice the difference. It just felt so soft. The only thing with this is, for starters, it's nearly £26 and you have to use a lot of it. So I don't know if you've seen it, but you use it on wet hair. You have to literally drench your whole head in this because it's supposed to make your hair like super sleek, less frizzy. You do use it like every 3 washes, but you still use a lot of product. You get 200ml in here, and I just think for £25, it is expensive, but I have been enjoying it. When you actually use it right and you don't use it sparingly, you can definitely tell the difference. It's so soft, and when you style it as well, you can definitely tell that you've used it. I think I would have to rebuy this, and this is definitely coming with me on holiday because I feel like it helps the humidity. There's actually videos as well of like doing the water test and water just runs off it, which my hair is a pain in the ass for. I mean, today it looks horrific because I've washed it today. On the day of washing, it just is horrible. So yeah, anything. I will try anything at this point because my hair is just a big frizz board all the time. So if there is any person to test this product, it's definitely me. The next hair product that I got, this is probably the latest trend on TikTok. Nature Spell Rosemary Oil. I did order the Miel one, and then whilst it was being processed, there was all these things of saying, it's for black people, don't use it on your hair, it'll fall out. So luckily, they refunded my money without me even asking. They must have known. So I ordered this instead. This one is £9, which I think is a great price as well. I thought they would have bumped up the price with it being so viral at the minute. You can use it literally everywhere, but last night I used it on my hair. I'm not gonna lie, I can't tell a difference this morning, but it did feel really nice to put in a treatment before I went to bed last night. I used to use castor oil, and that was a pain in the ass to lather your hair in. It smells so nice. It smells like spa, and it did wash out pretty easily. Like, there's no grease left in my hair whatsoever. I'm gonna keep using this because my hair, as you can tell, is horribly short, damaged, frizzy, just falls out, anything to help my hair. This girl uses bleach, so it's her own fault really. But will I stop? No. So I'm really hoping this works wonders. The reviews that I've seen on TikTok are unreal, where you can literally see people with like fresh hairs growing like all the way up here and things like that. So it looks like a miracle product. I will keep you informed because that is game changing. Nothing helps my hair. I've tried everything. So this is my last resort. Next up we have makeup. So these are the Dose of Lashes makeup sponges, and I did not need any more makeup sponges, but I got drawn in. You get 4 for £15 from Dose of Lashes. I've actually seen Shannon Mooney talk about these quite a lot and how good they are. Kind of like the marshmallow sponge. I'm sorry, it's dirty. And I don't know if you'll be able to see how small the box is, and then that's what it expands to. It goes absolutely massive, and this is only like half wet now. And then you've got the smaller one for like under the eye. Honestly, these are amazing. I prefer them to any other makeup sponge that I've used. The way they blend in foundation and concealer is insane. The finish is so flawless. I'm shook. If you buy anything, buy these if you are a makeup lover. I do love a flawless base, and this bloody helps. Like, the way this blends your foundation is absolutely unreal. Sure, Beauty Blender is like £15 for one, and here you get 4 and 2 different sizes. So nice, so soft, literally like bouncing a marshmallow on your face. So next up, I don't know if this is just me, but my For You page has been full of this brand, and Tatty Lashes. They are probably the more popular ones. So I don't know if I've already uploaded the TikTok that I've done and the shorts video that I did trying these eyelashes. I've put them back on today. I will try and do a little overlay, but these literally took me 10 minutes. And they are the eyelashes that you put on underneath your skin, a little cluster eyelashes. And I really enjoyed these. I will pop the video here of me actually putting them on. The brand Namiki, and this is the Dolly style. I absolutely love them. I've used a longer one on the outside and then smaller as you get in the middle. I tried to have a break from eyelash extensions and missed them so dearly, but it's expensive. So these are about £14, and you get all of these. Obviously, I've used a lot. I've been using them for nearly a week now, and what I will say is they are not like lash extensions. You might need to buy a stronger glue because this is the glue that it comes with, and they are basically just eyelashes. You pull them off really easily. Mine lasted for about 2 days. But on the day after I did them, I woke up and my eye was like stuck together. Through the night, they feel quite tacky. But I did take them off when I was on holiday, like before I went swimming and things like that. I say they could probably last you like 2 to 3 days, but I would be paranoid if I don't have them with me. I feel like I'd have to carry the whole kit with me all the time just in case, because, you know, they are thick clusters. So if one fell off, you're gonna look a bit bold. So that was my only concern. But I mean, £14, you get the glue, 2 spoolies, and then like this little applicator thing. They are super gorgeous lashes, to be honest. And if these lasted, I feel like I could be converted, because I actually prefer the way these look compared to my usual lash extensions. Really, really enjoying them. It's a shame that the glue isn't that long lasting. It is probably quicker to put on your own strip lashes rather than doing these like individually, but these look a lot more, obviously not natural, but you can't obviously see the band because they're all under your eyes. I'm the worst person for applying things, and I thought I'd blind myself. No, super easy. Honestly, definitely give them a go if you're a lash extension person, just to see what you think. Next up, we have something that is also going around recently viral. This is the Pixie Pen by Pink Honey, a nose contour pen. One thing I cannot do is contour, probably. I was going to say just nose contour, but I can't contour at all. This is a little pen. What shade did I get this in? I got this in the shade Bora Bora Baby. So it's literally just a little pen and looks like that. So that is what you are doing your nose contour with. I don't know if you've seen it, but oh my god, I'm awful at nose contour. Always looks so obvious. I'd appreciate a bit of nose contour because, you know, you literally like just draw the line, and because it's flat tipped. It's super easy. Blend it in with like a small dense brush, and it's probably the best my nose contour has ever looked. This is so, so creamy. Blends like a dream. I don't know if they already do. They need to do actual contour in this, because the shade as well is actually perfect for me. So you get loads and loads of product, and obviously because you're just putting on your nose, it's gonna last for freaking ages. So happy I bought this. This was £11, so not that bad really. I'm a fan of this. That is everything that I've bought from TikTok shop recently. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you were interested in getting your 15 free prints from Free Prints, then use my code I'll put on the screen, and I'll put it in the description box. Can't recommend them enough. Such a handy little app to have. Convenience, right here. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you've tried any of these things, let me know what you think. And if there's anything else you think I should try from TikTok shop, please let me know and I'll give them a go. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in my next video. Goodbye.